Welcome to the Jocular Spectalkular, where we jocularly talk spectacularly. I'm your host, Walter Mellon, and today my guest here is...
Old Gin and Tonic.
Old Gin and Tonic. Yes, indeed.
It's the Geo Metro of drinks.
Yes. Yeah, the reason why we're flying the old Geo Metro here is because my guest here drove a Geo Metro back in high school.
And drive is a very loose,
yeah,
it's a loose term.
That car just kind of lurches forwards. But yeah, and today we're playing Sky Rogue. This is the fake episode 4, because the real episode 4 of the Jocular Spectalkular got taken down due to copyright.
Really?
Yeah, me and Ajax made an episode where we were having commentary of Star Wars Episode 4, and you know, Fox are a bunch of bastards, and anyways, I took it down, and this is the new Episode 4, keeping up with continuity of playing Sky Rogue, and talking about Star Wars, maybe?
Maybe.
Yeah.
We'll see what I can bring to the table.
Yeah, how do you feel? Because I know you don't care much for Star Wars, you're not a big star head.
I care for Star Wars because it's kind of the pinnacle of culture. It's like this cultural phenomenon that everyone can get involved in.
Yeah.
Everyone knows about. So that's why I care about it.
Okay. Because you're a fair weather Star Wars guy.
There you go. That's me.
Yeah. So you're saying you watched Return of the Jedi, or Empire Strikes Back last night?
Yep. Saw Empire Strikes Back last night. Yeah, it's probably been about 10 years since I saw that movie.
Really? That's
really
a long time, man.
It's insane how bad the acting was.
See, I don't want to talk too much about The Force Awakens, but it's my favorite Star Wars movie. Landed that car perfectly.
Yeah. Right in the middle of the driveway there.
Yeah,
that's legit. So, I was pretty... actually kind of had an aha moment while I was watching the movie. You know, all these years, people really built up the fact that Lando Calrissian is the only black dude in Star Wars. But literally, the first scene in Cloud City, there's another black dude there.
Is there?
Yeah.
Cool.
This is double the diversity in The Empire Strikes Back. So that's
really, you're right. That
really,
is
really
double the diversity.
Happy to see that. Let's see. We get sandworms, we get Boba Fett. Yeah. Empire Strikes Back had it.
Sandworms is more of a Dune thing. I mean, the Sarlacc's not really a worm.
It was a giant worm.
It's not a worm.
Going through a giant worm-like cavern.
It's not a worm.
What defines a worm? If that's not a worm, I don't know what is.
Got a missile lock. Oh, God.
Nah.
So is this what flying... Also, my guest here is also a pilot. Is this what flying's really like?
Absolutely.
Absolutely. There we go. There you go, ladies and gentlemen. There you go.
Oh, God. You pretty much just... you hold the X button and stuff keeps coming out.
Yeah, just like a...
I learned everything I know from Ace Combat.
Yeah. That really is the best. Except for Ace Combat 7.
It's the best. All I know about it is the trailer.
Yeah.
All I've seen. And it was... and actually, it kind of made me happy, because in true Ace Combat fashion, it was all about this extended cutscene where they don't provide you any kind of information, and there's very limited amount of gameplay or fighter jets. It's just this dude standing on top of a platform,
yeah,
about to jump off it.
I'm excited, because that awesome carrier with the drones, I love fighting weird drones after Macross Plus, but anyways... Also, orbital elevators. I'm a big fan of orbital elevators in media. That's the thing the woman was standing on.
Okay. That's quite the accomplishment.
I know, bad.
It gives me a scientific boner just thinking about it.
Yeah.
But the best Ace Combat games in the past have
Ace
been
Combat
the ones...
Ace Combat 5, baby.
Yeah. Zero was pretty good.
You're into Zero more?
Zero was pretty good. I mean, they all pretty much end with you flying through a tunnel and blowing something up underground.
Five has you blowing up a falling satellite, though.
I'm sure you fly into it at some point, if my memory serves me correctly.
Hey, dude, you gotta give me your save file for Ace Combat 5, because I started playing it, and I don't want to have to go back and unlock all those planes, man.
Alright.
Cool.
I'll get you my memory card.
Cool. PS2. Best system ever.
Today's.
Yeah.
You could just swap memory cards with someone.
Yeah. Now you have to, like, do a USB thing and...
Yeah.
It's a whole ordeal. Oh, God.
Oh, why didn't you flip sideways?
I could have gone through there. Well, I'm no Poe Dameron if you know what I'm talking about, Star Wars Episode 7 fans.
Han Solo did it in Empire Strikes Back on the asteroid.
Yeah, that's right.
The Force is not strong with you.
No. It really isn't. You can dig this, man.
Ooh.
3, 2, 1, let's jam!
So, back to...
Yeah. So what's your favorite Star Wars movie? I mean, you haven't seen Episode 7 yet, but
I think my favorite Star Wars movie is Episode 7.
Really?
Just based on the trailers.
Oh, it's quite something. It is really good trailers.
I mean, whoever designed, put together those trailers should be nominated for...
A trailer? Trailing?
Yeah. Like an Oscar. Trailer Oscar. Do those exist?
No. They should.
They should exist.
Trailers are cool. I like watching trailers.
It tapped into my emotions like no other trailer
has
ever.
This movie, you're gonna love it.
It almost makes me not want to see the movie because
you
the trailer's so
you
good.
You really shouldn't. I mean, you can only get disappointed from actually seeing the movie.
That's a fact.
That's a fact. So something I've kept a secret for a long time.
No, here we go.
I think flying is really cool.
The cat is out of the bag.
Flight is really interesting to me, you know. But it's something I've never wanted to talk to you or Sid about because, like, oh, these guys are being nerds about it. But flying's really cool.
Wow.
Yeah.
You fucking nerd.
I know.
No, I love flying. I think.
What's the appeal to you?
The appeal of flight is being able to do whatever you want in whatever dimension you want.
Cool. I like that.
Although in a helicopter, you're pretty much going really, really slow. But you still do whatever you want in three dimensions.
So the appeal of flying to me is the speed. Like, you don't have to deal with running into an object or ground friction.
Mm-hmm. I hear that. Friction's the worst. Friction's like that guy you didn't invite to the party, but he showed up anyways. You're horrible.
I mean, me or the guy who showed up to the party?
Yes.
Oh God. I think I'm horrible. No.
But yeah, I played so much Ace Combat, and. I mean, Ace Combat is almost like a sandbox game, in a sense, because I mean, yeah, you're kind of patched into a mission, but, I mean, you can do whatever you want to. You can fly wherever you want to within the confines of the map. You can go up super high, you can fly down low through the buildings, and then you just restart the mission. There's no consequence.
Not really what defines a sandbox game, though.
Well,
I'll give it to you.
Think about how people play Grand Theft Auto.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, I would say like a majority of people They're just running around, running over people.
Yeah.
Smashing people, killing dogs. Killing
dogs. Weirdos going around killing dogs.
Just killing dogs.
Which I'm not happy to know that kind of person exists. That's very upsetting.
They are out there.
That was very upsetting to me.
I won't name names, but there are people that exclusively kill dogs in Grand Theft Auto.
Yeah.
But I mean, that's what comes to mind when I think of a sandbox game.
Is the ability to kill dogs.
The ability to...
and fly in planes.
The ability to explore a space with no set goal. It's not a side scroller where you have to go in one direction and then you have to fight this demon.
Yeah, look at that, an achievement. You got achievements in this game now.
Congrats, nice. Mate. 8 out of 8.
Yeah, no problem. 8 out of date. John and Kate plus 8. Mate. Are you going to get irate?
Oh, God. Your outdated cultural references are killing me.
What? Are you saying it's not like 2008? John Kate plus 2008?
It just keeps going.
Yeah, no, because this is the internet. We could release this at any... We could have recorded this at any time. No one knows when this was made.
The year 2021 is fantastic.
Yeah, it is. President Elizabeth Warren, narrowly avoiding World War III.
Spoiler alert!
Star Wars Episode 8 is the best Star Wars of all time. Ryan Johnson nailed it. He knocked it out of the park. He was out of the park.
You take that back.
I don't. What, are you saying Star Wars Episode 9 was better? That jackass who directed Jurassic World? That was the worst Jurassic Park movie. Well, 3. I don't count 3, though.
Casting John Krasinski in Star Wars was...
It was a bold choice.
Ill-advised, in my opinion.
Yeah, I like the guy, but I don't want to see him in a movie about Benghazi. I don't want to see him in my Star Wars.
Yeah, when he,
Like, him being one of the Knights of Ren? That's bananas.
Well, when he put the Sith Lord's stapler in a mold of Jell-O, I kind of jumped the shark.
Yeah, really did.
Speaking of jumping the shark...
Yeah, there's not enough sharks in, Jurassic World.
Megalodon.
You know, you see how it flew through that cloud? Oh shit, I got hit. In Ace Combat 7, it's gonna have physical clouds.
They'll
be like real objects. I don't know how the technology works.
I mean, you don't crash into them.
No, but I don't know how. I don't know how the technology works, man. But if you fly through them, it's gonna be like flying through a real cloud instead of just flying through a JPEG that's in the game.
I mean, I've flown through clouds. It gets pretty bumpy.
Yeah. Hopefully it'll be cool like that.
Vibration, some moisture in the windshield or something.
Oh. Ace Combat 7's gonna get moisture in my pants.
You know, that's a great point, is that there were no clouds in Ace Combat 5 or 0 or 4 or any of those.
Really?
I cannot think of a single cloud.
There's gotta be clouds.
No. I mean, there's haze. But that's just the game, like, not rendering a certain distance out in front of you.
Well, this is gonna have volumetric clouds whatever.
I mean, I'm actually pretty excited about that.
Yeah.
It's one of those things that's like, it's a nice to have. You don't realize that you miss it until you have it and it's taken away from you. I'm pretty excited. Clouds. Are they gonna release that on PC?
Hopefully.
Because I'm
you
done.
Would get that? You're not gonna get a console anymore?
I'm done buying consoles. Yeah. It's just, I can't justify it anymore.
I'd rather have it on PC so I could just play with you conveniently.
Yeah. You're out there sandboxing around in our jets.
Because, would I get VR for Ace Combat? Maybe.
It's all about price points for me.
Yeah.
Oh, look at this Falcon. Right through that cloud.
Favorite plane, man. Favorite plane from any game. It's so cool looking, man. There's no plane I like more than the Falcon. Look how cool it is, man. It's so sci-fi. Oh, shit, I'm stalled.
This one is from... AC-5,
yeah.
I'm sure.
There's the one from AC-0, too.
No, in Ace Combat 4, the Valkyrie, I think it was called?
No,
the white one?
That I thought this was in AC-4 also.
No. Definitely not. But the, I'm pretty sure it's called, maybe it's one of the Valkyrie, but it is pretty exceptional looking. Yeah, the wings that fold outwards. I think these wings fold outwards too, don't they? If you speed up, do the wings fold in?
No, these ones don't. Oh. That's the cool missile bays that open up. I mean, how could you not be splooshing over this plane? So goddamn cool.
Well, yeah, the cool that the cockpit is just a video camera.
Yeah. It's the way of the future, man.
Which seems insane.
Have you ever started flying Fire Scouts yet?
On the West Coast, they do.
It's a West Coast thing.
Yeah, I don't know how that happened, but I'm glad that I'm not a drone helicopter pilot.
Be a faceless goon. Assassinating people from a chair. That's what drone pilots do, man. No offense to what they do, but I mean...
That's what they do.
You're a faceless goon assassinating people from a chair.
And you save a hell of a lot of money doing it.
Yeah. Who needs boots on the ground when you have a man in a chair? Nah, you need boots on the ground.
Anyways. We need to rein ourselves back in.
Yeah, let's not talk about politics and how World War III is going to take place in Syria.
Oh, God.
Too real?
Spoiler alert.
Spoiler alert. Yeah, because we are recording from either 2008 or 2021.
Yeah, that's up to the listener to decide.
Spoiler alert, we got Osama bin Laden. And or war in Syria. Proxy war, because we're really fighting Putin's troops and Putin-backed troops in Syria.
This is a little social faux pas here, but I'm actually on my phone while we're recording here.
Oh, God.
I'm on...
You have to be present, man.
I'm on,
You have to be in the moment, dude.
I'm on Acepedia.
Ace Combat?
Yeah. Okay, here we go.
Of course that exists. Why wouldn't that?
Yes, I am actually the founder. All right, the XO2 Wyvern is my favorite plane.
Isn't that the one from Zero?
Oh, God. I gotta read.
Well, yeah, I mean... Reading is a basic thing in life.
Okay, it says Eurasia, so I'm pretty sure that's AC-5.
Well, they all take place on the same planet.
Do they? I thought it was like Final Fantasy where they occur in different universes.
It's,
Was I just not paying attention about these games?
No, I thought that was the case too, but apparently... Because I was reading some stuff from the... about AC-7. And they said they're going back to the world that 4 and 5 take place in.
Okay.
So, apparently it's the same world. And 0, too, I guess, since 0 is the prequel to 5.
Alright. This is Mobius 1 on here. I think Mobius 1 is AC-4. That first appeared in AC-4. The XO2 Wyvern.
Okay. Oh, that plane! Yeah! I totally know what you're talking about now.
Okay, here's a little sketch.
Yeah, no, I know. I know. Remember when Assault Horizon was a gigantic piece of shit? Yeah. It was the most recent one.
Oh, God, yeah. I rented that from a Redbox, which is the only video game I've ever rented. And, what a disappointment. Like, they took... So, you know, games have been going on this general trend over the past 10 years that cater towards this entitled generation that wants everything done for them.
Yeah.
So that's what video games have been doing. You hit a button and
things... And it does stuff for it. Assassin's Creed, Arkham Knight...
And it's horrible.
Yeah. Don't do that with Ace Combat.
Well, that's what they did with Ace Combat.
I know. It was shit. The follow mode or whatever.
Yeah. So now all of a sudden, like, you're not even piloting the aircraft anymore. You're just hitting X and your enemy dies. And it was the most disappointed I've been in a long time. So that game went back to Redbox. I think I even wrote a scathing review to you.
Yeah, no, we had a thing We had a Steam conversation about why it sucked, and I posted it on a blog on a website that doesn't exist anymore.
And that was either... That was either a year ago, or that was 12 years ago.
Yeah.
For the listeners.
Oh, God.
What are you doing?
We collided, and it's okay.
Oh, my...
You don't die instantly. Oh, God. So many missiles.
But anyways, so hopefully the new Ace Combat brings it back to the roots and doesn't cater to the entitled millennial.
It will in some capacity. I don't know how, I don't know when, but it will. It's probably going to have microtransactions,
I was just going to say, like, if it's got some kind of store with microtransactions...
Oh, it will, man.
I'm not going to participate in that.
Because the last Ace Combat game to come out was the free-to-play one, and it was all about that. You had to pay to refuel your plane. You can only play, like, one or two rounds a day, and then, like, if you want to keep playing, you have to fucking refuel your plane with real money.
See, that's just completely under the radar. Like, I'm not even aware that exists. So... But,
Ace Combat Infinity.
Could you get, like, hats for your pilot?
You should be able to. No, you probably have to buy new planes, too, or something.
Man, it's all about the hats. These kids love hats.
They do love hats. Hats are cool. I would buy a hat in real life.
Virtual hats.
Shit.
Team Fortress 2 started off at the beginning of the end. What are you doing?
I have to catch up. Are you saying this plane doesn't have a bayonet attached to it?
This isn't the Civil War, bro.
I beg to differ. No war is civil. No such thing as a civil war.
We've got a question from one of our listeners.
Okay, let's bring it on.
This is actually a live show.
This is, yes. Call-in show.
From J-Star.
A pre-taped call-in show. Are
you guys gonna watch Star Wars? I think he said it like that, too.
Yeah.
Star Wars.
Dude, I'm telling you, let's go see it tonight!
I can't see it
tonight. I won't post this until after you see it with your parents, so they won't know.
This has been a huge point of contention for us this evening. Apollo's kind of a player, if you will.
To wars or not to wars?
I mean, almost a predator. It's predatory how he does this. But he likes to take other people's V cards when it comes to movies.
Excuse me.
Yeah, so he'll snatch up the people that haven't seen the movie yet and go see it with them. And I'm like, I want to lose my virginity
with
someone else who's already losing their virginity.
Okay.
Yes, with my parents. It's just, you're both, you know, going through the awkward fluid exchange together.
Yeah. Gross. Don't put it like that. That is gross. Imperial. Oh, these mods, they messed up the skins. They're all off.
Let's see, in other news, we had a bang bang this evening.
Yeah, we ate two meals. It was very gross. Well, it was delicious and fantastic. But...
My taste buds are pleased. Very pleased. Fish burritos. Alright, what do we got going on here? TIE Fighter? Starfighter.
Yeah, TIE Fighter. Narrow dodge. You always gotta do the dodge, baby. I love the dodge. Auto cannon. Oh, I can't put the auto cannon on.
Let's see. Just had another message from...
J-Star?
From J-Star. He just watched a terrible, terrible movie called The Assassin.
Oh! Is that the one with, like, Jay Chow?
You know, I've never heard of it. So you're gonna have to take this one.
I don't know.
But he used two terribles, so...
It's gotta be bad.
It's gotta be bad.
I'm stalling. I mean, I'm not stalling. I'm more of a Lenin guy. Thank you, thank you. I'll be here all night. Can I land this way?
I'm gonna need more.
I think so.
In the Navy, we call this landing Chinese.
Do you?
Mm-hmm. Or down the throat. They're interchangeable.
I have a problem with that.
I'm not even joking.
That's a little Chinese landing.
I I don't know where it came from or why people say that, but landing backwards on an aircraft carrier,
that's,
it's called landing Chinese.
That's not cool.
I can't make this stuff up.
I'm not a PC person, but that seems like that has racist origins. Kind of like someone welshing on a bet or jerry-rigging something, you know?
Being an Indian giver.
Yeah. Well, daisies are very cheap.
You can't get this stuff up.
That's... no, you can't.
But, speaking of PC, how do you feel?
South Park is great, best season in years.
I was gonna say, were you able to watch South Park?
Best season in years.
I highly agree. I thought... I think the best part about this season... on top of the continuity, which I think the continuity's been a great refresh for Star Wars.
Like, which they introduced last season with the continuity stuff. That's the shot in the arm that show needed.
Exactly. Really, really perked him up and got my attention as a viewer. It made me want to keep watching.
Yeah.
I thought one great thing that it did for me is it's kind of like this variable interpretation. Like, I got out of South Park what I wanted to get out of it.
Yes.
And you might have got something slightly different, and they left that really open to interpretation. But I thought PC Principles.
Yeah, it was very... on point with its modern critiques of modern society.
Yeah.
Just like, yeah.
They push so hard to get a Whole Foods and then realize that they're pricing themselves out of a place to live. It's pretty awesome.
How do you feel about the X-Wing as a flyboy? How do you like its design?
I know this is a rehash of a prior conversation you've had on the show, but my input...
Because I want to get the input of a real flyboy, someone who's flown. I fly, I'm a pilot. Whoa! Hold on, we gotta talk about Independence Day 2 trailer.
Hey, one thing at a time.
Okay,
here.
Sorry.
One thing at a time here.
Sorry, yeah. You're right. It should be the host who's keeping the show focused, not the guest, but go on.
I understand your
excitement. That movie's been a long time coming.
But really, the bottom line on the X-Wing is that I think you open up the wing, you're doubling your surface area. You're
getting more drag, man.
You're getting more drag, you're getting more lift, you're more maneuverable.
Yeah.
I mean, it's like the monoplane.
I've seen a lot of things about World War I planes, buddy.
Okay. Hey, I'm not here to fight you.
No, you're not. I'm just here to crash into planes as they're falling out of the sky. But yeah.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're talking each other down here. Yeah. Our hands are off of each other's throats.
Yeah, we're in a level place.
We're ready. Oh, I lost my drink. Oh, there it is. We're ready to move on to a much more exciting topic of conversation.
Independence Day 2.
Resurgence.
Yeah.
Is that what it's called?
Yes. Okay. No Will Smith. That bums me out.
You know what's... I'm not going to name names here, but I literally... You know, in the trailer, they kind of strategically add a black man.
His son.
That's
Will Smith's son.
Which is pretty awesome. But I literally have had a couple people being like, yeah, it's so great that they brought Will Smith back.
What?
I'm like,
Are they joking or are they serious? That's a different guy.
No, they're very serious. I'm like, that was a different black guy.
They look so different.
You're going to have to rein yourself in there. I just wanted to throw that in there. I thought it was kind of funny. I think it's... I really enjoy when movies do that. You know, it's been 20 years or so since the last movie came out, and this one's going to be 20 years in the future. Mm-hmm. Kind of covers up some of the plot holes and whatever, people aging, yada yada.
Yeah.
It helps me connect to the storyline better. But I'm super pumped about it.
That's what I like about Star Wars Episode 7, where it's 30 years since Star Wars, since Return of the Jedi, and the movie takes place 30 years afterwards. And nice. Mm-hmm. Great success.
I like. 2 thumbs up. 8 out of 8, that's pretty great, mate.
8 out of 8, that's pretty great, mate. What is that? The fuck is that?
That's what
the fuck is that supposed to be?
Squeakers say in Counter-Strike. For those of you who don't know what a squeaker is, it's...
I don't.
A prepubescent boy.
Oh!
They're running rampant on the internet. It's a huge problem. Like, I wish there was, like, an 18-plus section of the internet.
What kind of weirdo kids are playing Counter-Strike nowadays?
I mean, Counter-Strike, you
just
can...
fucking play Call of Duty, kids. Leave,
you can buy it for $13.
Yeah.
I mean, they're just...
Leave Counter-Strike to the lonely, almost 30-year-olds.
Oh, God.
What?
It's... Yeah, it's true.
Like,
yeah, I want to play that game with other lonely, almost 30-year-olds.
Yeah.
And commiserate with each other. Like, I don't want to be commiserating and then some kid being like, oh my god, I almost killed you. Did you see PewDiePie on the internet today?
Yeah, I don't know why my Counter-Strike is still, like, the... After League of Legends and Dota, why it's, like, the third biggest esports game.
I don't know.
Because esports is... Like, mostly people in their younger 20s and shit who are into esports. Like, mid... I don't know. Esports is weird to me. I don't get it.
I can't say that I'm a participant.
But you play the third most popular esports game.
I want to be an e-athlete, not an e-spectator.
An e-athlete.
Yes, an e-athlete.
Remember how one of our friends was a mathlete?
I do.
Did we end up going to state one of those years?
I'm sure he did every year. That's how good he was.
he rode on Lawrence's and Charles's coattails.
Yeah. Yeah, he really did. I mean, the guy played trombone, for God's sake.
Yeah, he can't have that much brains if he's playing a brass instrument. In your face, brass instrument. Yeah. Woodwinds all day! Woodwinds all day!
All day!
All day!
What an ignorant.
I know.
Anyways, enough about that simpleton, Mr. Wilson.
Hey, no names, man. No real names.
It's Mr. No, it's a character from Dennis the Menace.
Dennis the Menace, yeah.
Old man Wilson. Anyways.
Yeah, by the way, my guest here is Hank Hill. You didn't say your name at all.
Well, yeah, I mean, I've gone by many aliases.
As if I.
You may have. I was in a trolling clan for a while called the Sailor Scouts. So if you were playing Counter-Strike in the year 2012, you may have encountered us on one of the Counter-Strike servers. Very obnoxious voice changers. This is an awkward. So the leader of the Sailor Scout clan,
yeah,
he like personally recruited me, and he basically Steam messaged me,
mm-hmm.
and the way he wanted me to quote unquote try out for the clan, he told me to like talk dirty to him. So we're in this like private Steam chat with like this stranger I've never talked to before in my life, and he goes, yeah, you know, you just talk dirty to me, like I want to hear you talk dirty to me.
Okay.
And I
never heard this part of the story before.
And I'm like, well, this is pretty damn awkward. So I can't kind of give a half-hearted attempt.
Yeah.
I didn't want to sell out right away. And he goes, you know, that's kind of weak. I don't think you're Sailor Scout material. and then I really, really went for it. And did well enough to land the job.
Nice.
So at that point, I was assigned the moniker Sailor Venus.
Nice.
26.
I was getting... You're the 26th Sailor Venus?
It was just... I think I was like the second or third Sailor Venus, but we got to pick our numbers. I was assigned an avatar and instructed on how to use a voice changer. And
nice.
A trolling we went. This is great times. Anyways, my love of trolling Counter-Strike servers eventually developed into...
Your own persona.
My own persona.
Not really your own persona, but...
But Hank Hill.
Yeah. You are quite known. Where you'll come on and people will be like, oh shit, it's Hank Hill.
Mm-hmm. Like the following.
Oh shit.
Back in the heyday.
Oh god.
In the year 2013. But it's all been downhill since then. Since then I've taken a much quieter stance and playing just for pleasure. How the hell did we get on this topic?
Want to end the show?
Yeah, let's end the show.
All right, goodbye, everybody!